The Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1739, Dots. Well, today's question is sent in by Jim. Jim is playing a game on the iPad called Dots. And the way that Dots works is you get a 6x6 grid, four different colored dots, and you're looking for patterns. And Jim wanted to know if there was a way in Excel to generate the 6x6 grid of the four different color dots. And so I downloaded Dots to the iPhone and checked it out. And what you're trying to do with dots is you're looking for connecting cells. So for example, in the dots game, you might draw a line from here to here. So we're looking for colors that are the same. And at this point, I could either go down to this one or I could have gone left. All right, there's no diagonals. And once I choose this, these five dots would disappear, and then Tetris-like, everything else would fall down, new dots would appear, and you're trying to get as many dots connected in 60 seconds as possible. So right now I've got the 6x6 grid working. Let's talk about how to do that. So I'm going to go onto the next sheet. We're going to choose a 6x6 range, equal RandBetween, 1, 4. RandBetween gives us an integer between 1 and 4, so that gets us the numbers 1 through 4. Every time we press F9, we get a new set of numbers. Simple enough, right? We're going to do Alt-O-D for conditional formatting. New rule, if the cell value is equal to a 1, then we're going to choose a font color. So we'll just choose the theme colors here. I'll go red for 1, and then OK. And we'll do the same thing. New rule, cells that contain equal to 2, format font color green. All right, so I paused the recording there, but I did the same thing to set up the rules for 3 and 4. Click OK, and now the font color is automatically changing. Let's set the column width, and let's just see here. This row 1 is a height of 15 with 20 pixels, so let's make column A also have 20 pixels. So it'll be nice and square. So that's 2.14. Alt-O-C-W, 2.14. So we have square cells now. And we'll center those. Now, how do we get the dots to appear instead of the numbers? Well, first, let's see if we can find the dots. We'll come out here to Insert, Symbol. And my recently used symbols, I have a nice black circle, the bullet character there. We'll click Close. And I will copy that to the clipboard, Control-C. All right, now here, let's go and select our range of cells, Control-1. The number format, no, we're not going to do that. We're going to go to Custom and say, hey, no matter what number shows up there, in quotes, I'm going to Control-V, put that dot character, click OK. All right, so now we have the grid that's working. All right, but I assume that Jim is probably trying to generate this that way he can kind of use Excel to help spot the trends or something like that, or spot the connections. And so I set up four new rules for this range. Use a formula to determine which cells to highlight, and all of these formulas are referring to B2, the top left-hand corner cell in the selection, if it's equal to, if it's equal to B1. All right, so if from this cell, if any of the adjacent vertical or horizontal cells are the exact same, then colored in gray, so that way I know, don't even look at these, the ones that aren't gray. The obvious choices are the ones that have the gray. But even there, it's still not going to help, because you need to be able to find the longest string. And so for example here, the longest one might be this particular range here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 would be the longest. And being able to detect the longest, that's one that seems a little bit tough. So, Jim, we have your question answer. We have the grid working. We can refresh the grid with F9. But as far as having this help you with the dots game to look for the longest particular chain, that is going to be a much tougher problem. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. Thank Jim for sending that question. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.